The idea of magnetic reconnection has been around for quite a while. And the basic idea is that if the sun's magnetic field lines point downward and the Earth's magnetic field lines point upward, when they meet, I can sort of break each of the two field lines in half and connect, let's say, the bottom ones to each other and the top ones to each other. And now I've connected a sun magnetic field line to an Earth magnetic field line. And then as it turns out, because there's a solar wind that flows away, those field lines get dragged away from the sun. And in that process, energy gets introduced into the Earth's magnetosphere, and that energy can get transferred to particles, causing things like the radiation belts and things like the aurora borealis. The overall kind of way I often like to explain what we do is with the concept of space weather. People are often told that space is empty, it's a vacuum. Well, that's true, but a vacuum doesn't mean nothing is there. There's just a little bit of something there. But space is so vast that that little bit of something can start to have significant effects over the scale sizes of how big space is. And so what we're really trying to do in the broadest sense is to understand the weather of space. It's hard not to be enthusiastic about this stuff because it's a set of measurements that this region, the Earth's cusp, has not really been focused on. And so both these magnetic reconnection effects, some of the things associated with the aurora that happen in this region, those are probably my two predominant interests of the project. And those, interestingly enough, form our basic science objectives